Today, a quick bonus video on Photoshop lens flare tips. Add neat lens flares to your images fast. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. I had a different video planned for today, but I ran into some issues. But that video is going to come tomorrow, so stay tuned for that. But today, something I've not done for a while on this channel, and that's a Photoshop tutorial. And today we're looking at lens flare tips. So here is my image opened up in Photoshop. It looks kind of bland right now, but we can vastly improve the image with simply adding a lens flare. You will need your layers panel open, which you can access in the window drop-down menu, or you can press F7 on your keyboard. A way that many people add a lens flare is quite a novice way, and I did this myself for a long period of time. Some people will simply go up to Filter, Render, and then Lens Flare, and they attach the lens flare onto the image layer. This will prevent you from being able to edit the actual lens flare itself, as you can see when I try to erase part of it here. So you may think, oh, just make a new layer and pop the lens flare onto that. You will see that you can actually apply a Photoshop lens flare right onto a blank layer. So the first lens flare tip is to select black as your foreground color, and then on a new layer, press the Alt Option key as well as Backspace or Delete, and then it will fill the entire layer with black. From here, change the blend mode to screen. What I can do now is apply the lens flare onto this layer, and I will be able to move it around and use the eraser tool to remove certain parts. You can apply as many lens flares as you wish in Photoshop, and it will automatically be in the same place as the previous lens flare. With a soft brush and a low opacity, I can then erase parts of the lens flare effect that I don't want on my image. I'm going to show you a few more tips to add dramatic effect to your images with a Photoshop lens flare. If I take the eraser tool to remove part of this colored glare on my lens flare effect, it will leave a gap in the coloration of the overall lens flare. To counter this, take the eyedropper tool and sample a color from the actual lens flare itself. And then with the brush tool, set it to a low opacity and carefully paint in the gap. Now this may take some time to get right, and I've kind of rushed it here on the tutorial. But if you do make a mistake, you can simply press Command or Control Z to move back a step. The idea is to make everything blend and flow naturally across the lens flare effect. If you want to see more videos like this one, I may add one or two Photoshop tutorials per month on my channel. However, Satori Graphics will always be more geared towards Adobe Illustrator, simply because that's what I know best. But let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. But as you can see, turning off the lens flare layer, it has quite a dramatic effect. From here, I would start using the Dodge and Burn tool, as well as other effects to enhance the dramatic lighting and the feel of the image. I can always show you these in future videos if you guys want to see that. Remember to drop your thoughts down in the comment section below. Also, let me know if you feel this time slot is better than the previous one. I'm going to be back tomorrow with my last video of this week, so be sure to tune in for that. Subscribe for weekly graphic design content, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.